Charles Tumwesije, the Deputy Director of Field Operations at the Uganda Wildlife Authority, says that between the years 2011 to 2013, Uganda was listed among the world's top illegal wildlife transit routes. Tumwesije says that previously, wildlife traffickers were using Uganda as a route to smuggle out several large consignments of mainly ivory, which is not the case today. He explained some of the measures put in place to address wildlife crime.
We have brought dogs, canines. Previously, we were not using dogs in detecting wildlife crime. Now, the beauty with the dogs is that the dogs cannot be corrupted. Human beings can be corrupted. So when you use dogs and train them, they are able to sniff rhino horns, they are able to sniff ivory.
He, however, said that traffickers have now changed tactics and are attempting to traffic wildlife treasures in small amounts.
They changed. So now what we are seeing is that people are breaking these seizures. So you find we are arresting people with 2 pieces, 5 pieces, 20 kilograms.
Tumwesije disclosed that they will stretch investigations into financial intelligence so as to penetrate the network of criminals who finance the activity.
The people you normally arrest, you either arrest the poacher, but when you investigate, you find that this person has been hired. There is somebody somewhere sitting in a hotel who is sending money, and this money is the one that is being used to kill this animal.
Moses Olinga from the International Fund for Animal Welfare has attributed the reduction of wildlife crime in Uganda to the coordinated efforts of the National Anti-Wildlife Crime Coordination Task Force.
To coordinate efforts against poaching, trafficking and wildlife crime generally in the country.
Conservation and security authorities have increased interagency collaboration and the country now has a joint wildlife coordination task force. This task force comprises agencies like the Uganda Wildlife Authority, customs officials, Uganda Police, the Uganda People's Defense Forces, and the Financial Intelligence Authority, among others.
There has been a coordinated, concerted effort among the law enforcement agencies, both nationally, regionally, and internationally. And that has kind of paid some dividends in a way that we've now narrowed the way these syndicates operate.
It aims at strengthening coordination among different agencies to combat wildlife crime. George Owoyesigyire from the Ministry of Tourism has stressed the need to reduce human wildlife conflict and to also create community awareness about the benefits of wildlife.
We need to reduce the hostility and the conflict between humans and wildlife.
Wildlife crime remains a significant obstacle to conservation in Uganda, and during the COVID-19 lockdown of 2020-2021, the Uganda Wildlife Authority registered an increase in poaching. The worst scenario happened when 6 lions were killed in Queen Elizabeth National Park in 2020. Story by Rogers Sandy for the news.